Hey guys, in this video, we will have a look at Nusantara Project 4.0 official build, which is based on Android 12. As you can see, stock kernel is Predator Stormbreaker X 4.10, which is a EAS kernel. Under Nusantara Wings, we can find some useful customization. Theme is now available and you can change Mone colors plus Nusantara Wings background. There are some options are not available yet, such as notification, lock screen and some others. For battery options, there is two new styles and you can change battery text position as well. From quick settings customization, you can change brightness slider related settings for now, as you can see here. Also, the traffic indicator works fine without any issues. Under Hardware tab, only navigation settings have some options to tweak navigation as your liking. Under Display settings, you can change body font from here and most of the thing is similar to other custom rooms. Wallpaper and Styles supports themed icons for stock launcher. There is no extra security features under security settings, and by the way, as you can see, my device is not encrypted and somehow secured lock screen is working. Secured lock screen is screen lock and fingerprint. I will make a video on it soon, so subscribe for that so that you won't miss it. For rooted users, safety net is passed only after enabling Magis card, and it is passed by default for non-rooted users. And Widevine is certified as L1 by default, so that it means you can play HD content on Amazon Prime Video and Netflix. I don't have any subscription to those, so I can't test it. Geekbench score is good, or I should say average, because it is very close to Android 11 custom ROM score. CPU throttling test looks pretty good, and the test was done with Nexus Extreme version 2 kernel for both of the benchmark tests, and the threads were set to 20 for the CPU throttling test. We're capturing C.
Hello there.
Please don't kill me.
Changing mag. Coming for you.
Okay.
Ooh, this is good.
Changing mag. Dog is inside. Enemy down.
Wait a minute. Who are you?
Enemy down.
Hell no.
Well done.
Watch out!
Heavy machine gun.
Gaming is pretty great with stock and Nexus Extreme kernel. With screen recording at 2340x1080 at 60fps, which is device max resolution, the game ran pretty smooth. Just some minor frame drops that I faced while screen recording. So if you want to play some games on this ROM, then I will suggest you to use Nexus Extreme version 2 kernel and don't flash QTI version, just go with normal old cam version. Overall, the performance is great. The performance with this custom ROM is pretty great and I didn't face any sort of lag in UI or anywhere. Also, the gaming performance is great too. If you're a customization lover, then this custom ROM won't satisfy you. Never mind, but the customization you will get is good enough for most of the users, in my opinion. If you are concerned about banking apps, then don't worry, as banking apps will work fine as the safety net is passed by default. I personally use them and I use Paytm, Google Pay and a Kotak Bank app. With L1 certification, you can watch HD content without any worries on OTT platforms like Amazon Prime Video and Netflix. For cons, I don't think there is any issue with this custom ROM, cause most of the thing that I tested was working fine. So as I mentioned in pros and cons, there is no issue with this custom ROM and I didn't face any bugs so far. Performance and stability of this custom ROM is pretty great, and if it is combined with Nexus Extreme version 2 kernel, then the performance stonks. So if you want max performance without using any module, then the best combo is Nexus Extreme version 2 plus Nusantara 4.0, and I think you can run games like Genshin Impact with less frame drops. Overall, this custom ROM is smooth and stable.
That oughta hold it.
Cha cha, real smooth. Let's go to work.
Also, the customization is good, and soon we will get more customization. So far, this is the most stable custom ROM that I used, which is based on Android 12. So don't just wait there, and now go for it. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe. Also, follow me on Instagram. Dancing on the moon.